In part 4 of our lesson on sum and difference identities for cosine, we will derive and use the cofunction identities. Recall that the cosine of a minus b is equal to the cosine of a times the cosine of b plus the sine of A times the sine of B. Now let's apply that to the cosine of pi over 2 minus theta. We will get cosine pi over 2 times cosine theta plus sine of pi over 2 times the sine of theta. Now we can fill in the values for cosine of pi over 2 is 0, and that has to multiply cosine theta, plus sine of pi over 2 is equal to 1, and that has to multiply sine of theta. So this will simplify to sine of theta, and we've just proven that the cosine of pi over 2 minus theta is going to equal sine of theta. We've proven this cofunction identity using the difference identity for cosine. Next, we'll start from the Pythagorean identity of sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. And we'll assume that theta is in quadrant 1, where all the trig functions are positive. We're going to take this equation and solve it for sine of theta. So we would get sine squared theta is equal to 1 minus the cosine squared of theta, which means that sine of theta is equal to plus or minus square root of 1 minus cosine squared theta. And because we are in quadrant 1, we can say then that sine of theta, we know, would have to be positive square root of 1 minus cosine squared of theta. We can use this now to rewrite the sine of pi over 2 minus theta as the square root of 1 minus cosine squared of pi over 2 minus theta. Remember, whatever the argument is here would go here. So the argument of pi over 2 minus theta has to go here. Now we'll use the cofunction identity that we just proved, which says we can replace cosine of pi over 2 minus theta with sine of theta. So that's going to substitute in here, and this will become the square root of 1 minus sine squared theta. Now we can use the Pythagorean identity that says that 1 minus sine squared of theta is equal to cosine squared theta, and we can substitute that in. So this is the square root of cosine squared theta. We know in algebra that the square root of x squared is equal to absolute value of x, so we're going to substitute that in, and this becomes absolute value of cosine theta. And because we are in quadrant 1, cosine theta must be positive, so the absolute value of cosine theta is just cosine theta. And be sure to put a note. This is because theta is in quadrant 1. So now we've just proved the other cofunction identity, that sine of pi over 2 minus theta is equal to cosine theta. Now we can use these two results to prove the other four cofunction identities. We know that tangent of pi over 2 minus theta is going to equal sine of pi over 2 minus theta divided by cosine of pi over 2 minus theta. Now, using the identities, we know we can replace sine of pi over 2 minus theta with cosine of theta. And we can replace cosine of pi over 2 minus theta with sine theta. Cosine theta over sine theta can be replaced with cotangent theta. So we've just proven that tangent of pi over 2 minus theta is equal to cotangent theta. Now let's check your understanding, and you go ahead and prove these other three in a similar fashion to what we just did here. Then restart the video when you're ready to check your proofs against mine. We know cotangent of pi over 2 minus theta is going to be cosine of pi over 2 minus theta divided by sine of pi over 2 minus theta. We know cosine of pi over 2 minus theta can be replaced with sine theta. Sine of pi over 2 minus theta can be replaced with cosine theta. And sine theta over cosine theta is replaced with tangent of theta. So we get that cotangent of pi over 2 minus theta is equal to tangent theta. Here, secant of pi over 2 minus theta is equal to 1 divided by the cosine of pi over 2 minus theta, which is 1 divided by, we know cosine of pi over 2 minus theta is going to be replaced with sine theta. 1 over the sine of theta is going to get replaced with cosecant of theta. So we just proved that secant of pi over 2 minus theta is equal to cosecant theta. Finally, cosecant of pi over 2 minus theta is equal to 1 divided by the sine of pi over 2 minus theta. Using the identity, we know this is going to turn into 1 over cosine theta, because sine of pi over 2 minus theta is getting replaced with cosine theta. 1 over cosine theta becomes secant of theta. So we just proved that the cosecant of pi over 2 minus theta is going to equal secant of theta. And next, we'll get some practice applying all of these cofunction identities. So we just proved all six cofunction identities, and we've learned before that we can sum that up by saying that cofunctions of complementary angles are equal to each other. So in this example, where we have to write each in terms of its cofunction, we know that the cosine of 2 pi over 9 means we just set it equal to the cofunction, which is sine, of its complementary angle, which is pi over 2 minus 2 pi over 9 in radians. This becomes the sine of, we see that our common denominator will be 2 times 9, which is 18, and we just think of the cross products, 9 pi minus 4 pi. So this turns into the sine of 5 pi over 18. Now you go ahead and try these next two examples. So pause the video and restart when you're ready to check. The cotangent of 4 pi over 5 will equal its cofunction, which is tangent, of the complementary angle, which will be pi over 2 minus 4 pi over 5, which equals tangent of our common denominator, will be the product of the two denominators, which is 10. Then we take the cross products, 5 pi minus 8 pi, which is equal to the tangent of negative 3 pi over 10. And we notice that this could be simplified by the negative angle identity, so this becomes negative tangent of 3 pi over 10. Secant of 32 will be the cofunction, which is cosecant, of the complementary angle, which, since we're in degrees, we'll say 90 minus 32 degrees, which is the cosecant of 58 degrees. In this example, we're being asked to solve for theta. Now we notice that we have secant on the left-hand side and cosecant on the right-hand side. We need the two trig functions to be the same, so we can take either side and turn it into its cofunction. Maybe we'll do the left-hand side, since it will be a simpler substitution due to the simpler argument. So secant of theta turns into cosecant of 90 degrees minus theta. I knew to use degrees because the angle over here on the right-hand side was in degrees. So the right-hand side remains the same, cosecant of 5 theta minus 6 degrees. We know that we have to get at the argument, so to undo the cosecant function, we're going to have to take cosecant inverse of the left-hand side and the right-hand side. So the left-hand side becomes the cosecant inverse of the cosecant of 90 degrees minus theta. And on the right-hand side, we have to do the same thing. Take the cosecant inverse of the entire side, which is cosecant of 5 theta minus 6 degrees. Make sure that you're showing this step in your work. Definitely on your exams, I'll be looking for this step to be shown in your work because it's the only way to get rid of that cosecant. When you take an inverse function of a function, you are left with the argument. So we get 90 degrees minus theta is equal to 5 theta minus 6 degrees. Combining like terms here, we're going to add 6 to both sides. And we can see that we will also want to add theta to both sides. So the left-hand side becomes 96 degrees. The right-hand side becomes 6 theta. Dividing both sides by 6, we're going to get that theta is equal to 16 degrees. In this example, we are being asked to fill in the missing trig function. Now, notice that 50 degrees and 40 degrees are complementary angles. And we know that cofunctions of complementary angles are equal to each other. So that would mean that sine of 50 degrees would equal cosine of 40 degrees. Now when we look up here at the original problem, we see that the 40 degrees is in the denominator. So we know that cosine of 40 degrees would equal 1 over the secant of 40 degrees. So since the trig function has to be in the denominator, that means that's the trig function that has to go here. Secant. In this example, we are asked to fill in the missing angle. And we have cosine of 3 pi over 5 has to equal sine of some argument. Now, because these two are cofunctions, then these two angles, we know, have to be complementary. So to figure out the missing angle, we know we're going to do pi over 2 minus 3 pi over 5. To subtract those two, we get the common denominator of 10, and we have to do the cross products in the numerator. 5 pi minus 6 pi, which works out to be negative pi over 10, and so there's our argument.